there, Cultaholic. My name is Jim Sterling, and why should you pay attention to me? Because I am an accomplished critic, I'm an accomplished raconteur, I'm a professional wrestler, sort of. I got a shirt, and I know professional wrestlers anyway, like the Ursa Major and Rey Fury.
Yeet.
Yeet indeed. So, this is me for Cultaholic, and this is why Kevin Owens is WWE's top babyface. Join me. Kevin Owens is the biggest babyface in WWE right now, and if you disagree, you're morally bankrupt and quite possibly an evil person. Throughout his career, Kevin Owens / Kevin Steen has been known as a bloodthirsty prize fighter with a willingness to fight and hurt anybody he comes across. Using his family as an excuse, he would regularly justify his actions as necessary for taking care of his kids, while unnecessarily crossing the line to do so. In modern WWE, such a characterization is far too complex, predominantly because it's a character and not a t-shirt design, but that's a topic for another day. Speaking of t-shirt designs, Owens' Fight Anyone tee looks woefully outdated now he's been drained of his former personality and has become a stock-in-trade cowardly heel, one of the few heel types WWE is capable of nowadays because it's simple and can be explained to anybody in two words: cowardly heel. There, that's the sum total of a character now. Owens does his best to inject a persona and his natural charisma into the promos he's given to work with, but his characterization has been, like everything else, boiled down to base components. Not that cowardly heels don't work, but the problem with Owens is that he isn't a heel. In fact, he comes off less like a coward and more a justifiably traumatized victim who doesn't want to be bullied anymore. Owens started his face run when he went up against Shane McMahon, a man who legitimately screwed him out of the US title against AJ Styles with questionable guest referee decisions at SummerSlam 2017. When Owens had his rematch, it was decided Baron Corbin would be guest referee, Constable Corbin now. Hello. But Corbin up and left partway through the match, leading to Shane rushing out there to count the pin for AJ Styles. A non-referee went out to replace the referee, jumping at the chance to screw Owens over and using the distraction of his appearance to secure AJ the title. That's what it was, a classic screwjob, because Shane was a corrupt heel presented as the hero of the piece, somehow. But it would only get worse for Owens. With a legitimate grievance, Kevin demanded another rematch but was barred from having another shot while Styles remained champion. This led to a frustrated Owens bringing up McMahon's children, which caused Shane to absolutely lose his piss and beat the holy hell out of the man. The crowd cheered and celebrated while a boss physically assaulted his employee, having escalated a verbal encounter to a physical one. In any other business, this is grounds for a lawsuit, and Kevin was right to make that his next move, laying out his plan to take Shane to court and clean the bugger out. Cue the devil himself, as JR used to put it, Vince McMahon. Daddy had come to bail out his son. He said he regretted that Shane didn't beat his victim up harder and told him if he tried to sue WWE, Mr. McMahon would use his bottomless wallet to lawyer up and destroy Kevin Owens. And the crowd cheered. They cheered for a situation in which a billionaire threatened to ruin an employee for wanting recompense over a goddamn physical assault. 20 years ago, Vince McMahon would do things like this to Stone Cold Steve Austin routinely and get booed out the building. Nowadays, we're expected to side with the mega rich and crap all over their victims. I mean, it's a perfect analogy for life outside wrestling, except WWE played it totally straight and legitimately presented Vince as the face. It was despicable and disgusting and pure heel. Kevin Owens is the modern-day Stone Cold, but in a cruel twist, the world has decided he's evil for it. After getting Vince's assurance he could put his hands on a McMahon, the prize fighter headbutted and frog-splashed the WWE chairman to holy hell. And at this point in time, I'd like to remind you that Steve Austin once beat this man up while he was hospitalized, and we loved him for it. He twatted him in the head with a kidney dish. By comparison, what Owens did wasn't all that bad, and if anything, he's more justified in doing what he did than Austin ever was. The rest of the McMahon-Owens feud saw Shane Shane become obsessed with destroying Kevin's career, and he was only vaguely hinted at maybe going a tiny little bit too far with it. Whenever Owens would lash back at his treatment, he was presented as a ruthless monster or a whiny boy, when again he was behaving exactly how massive baby faces have behaved when mercilessly toyed with by a McMahon. Hell, he's less whiny and entitled than Roman Reigns is presented as being. Shane had literally tried to destroy Kevin's career at Hell in a Cell 2017, and if it wasn't for Sami Zayn turning face, yes, face, to rescue Owens from a leap of faith off the top of the cage, the evil Shane McMahon would have gotten his wish. After yet more torment from Shane, the duo of Sami and Kevin would be fired by Daniel Bryan for an attack on the commissioner that, once again, was nowhere near as bad as many beatdowns we'd seen before. Though it was funny when Shane was on the floor going, "Oh, Eventually, Kevin and Sami made their way to Raw, where they were immediately treated like pond scum by general manager Kurt Angle for no apparent reason. He wanted nothing to do with them and has spent his time ever since toying with and mistreating Kevin Owens, his erratic decision-making putting the poor guy in the way of Braun Strowman constantly. Speaking of Braun, his recent feud with Owens has only cemented the man's position as babyface in my opinion. Poor Kevin spent weeks being barreled over by Braun without provocation, and was targeted as the victim of what can only be described as bullying. I guess we only care about bullying in the WWE during whatever month an anti-bullying campaign is sponsoring the company. Insincere bastards. Owens has tried to make friends with Strowman, actual friends, but Strowman, who has never been victimized by Owens at all, kept running him over, kept chasing him through arenas, tipped his car over once. He's been slamming him and bashing him and pushing him over in a porta potty and covering him in poo, and Kevin Owens rolled around in the poo and got poo in his hair, and he got blue chemicals all over him, which probably could have blinded him, probably. And the crowd cheered as they watched a man be victimized and brutalized and mocked week in and week out. He should be the most sympathetic face in WWE history, and yet we're meant to boo him. Why? What villainy has he committed since 2017? What unforgivable evil has he inflicted on the world that we cannot feel sorry for the man who is constantly, thoroughly targeted by bullies? His only crimes of late have been to stand in the wrong place at the wrong time and maybe have a bit of an attitude problem. Kevin Owens has become the epitome of the designated villain, the baddie we're told is a baddie despite him not doing anything particularly bad. But to me, he's a face, the biggest face going, because of what WWE is showing me. They're showing me a beaten down hero who has become a coward out of sheer bloody necessity. I'd be terrified of getting into a WWE ring too if I was mistreated and bullied the way Kevin Owens is. The fact he's treated like a bad guy only makes him more sympathetic to me, because Kevin Owens did nothing wrong. Alright, as I record this epilogue, SummerSlam has just concluded, and you'll have to forgive my croaky voice. The great Stardust was yelling up a storm at the PWE show we just did, and he used my vocal cords to do it. But I had to record this final bit. As I speak, Kevin Owens has just been destroyed. He might as well have stayed in that porta potty, because that's where they've just flushed his credibility. He went out there and got flattened by Braun Strowman in less than 2 minutes, and for why? For why? So that Braun Strowman could be used at the main event as a trick to keep people from leaving and chanting beat the traffic, and to stop them dumping all over Lesnar Reigns. Seriously, Strowman was there to literally trick people. And after months of being humiliated and bullied by Braun Strowman, all Kevin Owens amounted to was collateral. The most damaged kind of collateral, the utterly squashed kind. And as if that wasn't bad enough, it wasn't even notable as a squash because it was one of three squashes that night. There is no justice for KO, and that's what we need right now, justice for KO. But no, people thought what happened at SummerSlam was the justice. They cheered and they celebrated because they think KO deserves this, and he deserves nothing because KO did nothing wrong. And all he's doing now is being a joke. One of the best they have, and he's a joke. All I've learned this week is that good people suffer. Good people suffer at the hands of their tormentors. Oh, it's a bloody disgrace. Anyway, I'm gonna go be sad about it now. Hope you liked the video. Bye.